CNN's Brent Weber has more on the man who could be the Trojans' best player.
From the beginning, there's been no doubt as to which man the Trojans' national championship hopes have been hitched. Los Angeles, the entertainment capital of the world, quickly caught on to something Keyshawn Johnson's coach knew long ago. This guy has what it takes to be a star.
He has a real exuberance for life, for doing what he does. Life seems like it's supposed to be fun to him, and he makes it that way. I think he's got tremendous ambition to succeed, and he's got great charisma. The combination of those two, and God gave him some real gifts, too.
Those gifts landed him in the record book this season when Johnson set an NCAA mark with his 12th consecutive 100-yard receiving game. After putting on 20 pounds in the offseason, at 6'4", 210 pounds, Keyshawn draws comparisons to the likes of Michael Irvin and Jerry Rice.
Leadership on the football field, able to catch the ball, block, make yards after the catch, defenses adjust to me. You know, sitting down, studying the game, trying to learn from the best that ever played the game. Those things is what makes me, you know, who I am.
He has a sense inside him where he says, these people are still not going to stop me no matter how many people they put on me. And you throw a ball up in a crowd, and he has the mentality where he's going to come down with the ball.
Keyshawn Johnson grew up on the notoriously mean streets of South Central L.A., had his own scrapes with the law, landing in juvenile hall for misdemeanor theft as a teenager.
You learn a lot growing up over here. You know, I say one thing, though, if you can survive on these streets, believe me, you can survive a long ways in a whole lot of different areas around the world, and you can cope with a lot of different situations, and that's something that I learned to do.
Fortunately for Keyshawn, USC's campus was just a stone's throw from home, and the football team became his family. From age 7 to 14, he was the Trojans' ball boy and all-around gopher. And in turn, the experience helped Johnson become a success story rather than a statistic.
Obviously, it's great to see a young man evolve from that time, and I don't know if we had any impact on him, but it's nice just to see him become what he's become, and I'm quite sure he's going to be getting even better.
The best players that have ever played for USC have always been leaders. Mm-hmm. You know, you look at the Ronnie Lott was always a leader on the football field. That's something that I try to do. I just try to lead my team, and mostly by example.
One former Trojan Keyshawn remains close to is Tim Shannon, a relationship that caught the attention of the NCAA prior to this season. There were allegations that Shannon, now a sports agent, gave money to Johnson while Keyshawn was playing football at LA Community College before coming to USC. The NCAA has yet to rule, but an internal investigation left USC officials confident there'd been no wrongdoing.
It's like a father figure of mine, so he's always taking care of me. Every time I need something from Timmy, I'll call him and say, hey, I need this advice for this, that, and the other, and he'll give it to me.
And today, Keyshawn is taking care of the Trojans' hopes for a return to glory. He could have left college after his junior season to chase down the riches of the NFL, except there was work still to be done around the old neighborhood.
Coming back, having an undefeated season, having a chance to play for a national title against maybe Ohio State in the Rose Bowl, all that stuff is just a dream.
In Los Angeles, Brent Weber, CNN Sports.